Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind, now beginning the Black Pits, additional content for the, only found in the Enhanced Edition. Now, before I go into this, just a quick note, please no spoilers for anything. No spoilers for this game, Siege of Dragonspear, or Baldur's Gate 2. I've had three people leave me, admittedly, minor spoilers for, Baldur's Gate 2, but come on, I have not even installed the game yet. Someone told me about a certain character to pick up, to find this character somewhere. Someone told me about a weapon to find, and someone else told me about, for lack of a better term, because I don't want to spoil either, a place to discover or something like that. I don't want to give spoilers myself, so I'm not being, you know, giving details, but please nothing, so don't tell me anything. Don't tell me a spoiler, don't tell me anything that, about anything that I haven't already come across. And since I have not come across anything in Baldur's Gate 2, please not tell me anything about Baldur's Gate 2. Ditto for Siege of Dragonspear, ditto for the rest of the Black Pits, whatever I don't get to, and the rest of Baldur's Gate 2. The rest of the first Baldur's Gate, please. I appreciate it if you do not do so. Even though there are minor spoilers, if 20 people tell me little things, then I know way too much, and this is a blind playthrough. So I already know three things about a game that I have not even installed, and I'm going to start blocking people who do so. Even if you have not done so before, say next week someone leaves a spoiler and I have no idea who this guy is, first comment ever, I'm blocking that person. So, do not do it. I don't want to block people. I had so much problems with that during the Mass Effect playthrough. You wouldn't believe, even though I had the, you know, I put spoiler warnings all over the place, including in the beginning of the video, playing in the video. So, please not do so. I don't want to block anybody, and I don't want to be spoiled, so if you don't leave spoilers, you won't get blocked, and it's a win-win scenario for everybody. So, I hate to say that, but, you know, I have to come out and say that, you know, but unfortunately it's necessary, so in we go for the Black Pits.
Come on! Come on! Feast your eyes upon the most marvelous martial magnificence that the Underdark has to offer. I, Baeloth the Entertainer, cordially invite you to join the audience of my latest spectacle, the Black Pits!
Well, that was loud. So Baeloth we ran across in, I think, the Larswood? He fell out of the sky or something like that, or reappeared. It was quite a while ago in the playthrough. Yeah, it was interesting. This is bound to be interesting as well. I'm assuming the options are all the same? I'm assuming these are. You got ambient here, sound effects, voice is high, music. I'm trying to like kind of memorize this, see if it's the same, because that seemed loud. And then. It is the same, right? Yeah. I think. If not, it's pretty close to it. Alright, so let's.
Come!
Okay, so. Single player. New game, pre-generated character. Load game. Import game. Okay, so I can't. Okay. So I have to start a new character. What? Could I import my own party? Probably, right? I mean, what else would there be? But you figure, if you're going to import something from the main game itself, you figure it would show up here, right? You wouldn't have to do anything. I'm just gonna go new game. Okay. Well, Meryl? Do you just choose all these people? Zelnick, Andor, Gallus, Talana, Rianne? Wait. If I choose all of them, wait. Oh, it's never mind. I didn't realize it said delete. I was clicking this and didn't even realize it said, I thought it was select. That's weird to have it show up and have delete. So, okay, I can get some. Okay, we've got. A fighter. Information. Okay. Oh, we've got biographies for them too. Okay, so Meryl's the fighter. A fan of strong drink and boisterous tales, Meryl is an unlikely leader of men and women alike. She has spent most of her nascent adventuring career in taverns and inns across Cormyr, rather than plundering dungeons and slaying dragons like any proper adventurer should. Most recently, Meryl lashed her current party together with the promise and intention of investigating some nearby ruins. Before the group could get moving, however, they spent a solid week drinking and sharing tales across a dizzying array of taverns. It was within one of these taverns that a flash of light and the smell of stale cavern air signaled her arrival to the Black Pits. Okay. Talana is a mage. Lawful evil, really. Are you evil too? She's chaotic good. Talana sees herself as an excellent example of professional evil, hard at work in our day-to-day lives. She takes a very pragmatic approach to cruelty and terror, applying them only when it is absolutely necessary to further her selfish goals. When Meryl offered Talana a sum of money for the use of her magical talents, the sorceress had planned to refuse and perhaps burn the skin off of Meryl if she refused to give up her purse. Instead, she realized that if she were to betray the party at a critical moment, she could march out of the ruins with far more than her fair amount of treasure. Talana is understandably upset that she now rots within the Black Pits, unable to carry out her plan until everyone escapes. Okay. And then we have Gallus, who is a chaotic neutral half-orc barbarian. Descending from the north, Gallus is a man. Gallus is actually a character in Skyrim. Yeah. You meet him as a ghost, actually. Descending from the north, Gallus is a man who only respects an individual based on their martial ability. He considers the weak, inexperienced, and clumsy to be far beneath him, regardless of their social standing. This has contributed to his distaste for visiting cities, but has not stopped it altogether. Cities provide coin, and for a barbarian, Gallus has expensive tastes. Signing up with Meryl was previously an excellent career move for Gallus, as his responsibilities seemed to only involve drinking and embellishing stories. His recent abduction to the Black Pits has made him reconsider his enthusiasm for the job. Okay. And Rhianne is a neutral, evil, female dwarf cleric, priest of Talos. These stats are not bad, actually. They're pretty good stats. Let me just look at... for a mage, yeah, dexterity would be better for the armor class. But... otherwise... pretty decent. And then Meryl. Not bad. Gallus is the barbarian. Hey, yeah, typical. Intelligence 9. Same as, Minsk. Strength 19. Sweet. Okay. He's our heavy hitter. As long as we can find him a good weapon. Rhianne. Wisdom 16. Yeah, she's got really good stats, actually. Rhianne Thunderburp, or T-Burp, what? As she prefers to be called, is an anomaly among dwarves. She worships Talos, an aspect of the orcish god Grumsh, the hated enemy of entire race. What? When asked to explain this discrepancy, Rhianne merely grunts and stomps her enormous warhammer. Immediately following, a thunderclap can be heard in the distance, regardless of how clear the sky may be, or the day may be. She feels this to be a satisfactory answer despite frequent claims to the contrary. Enlisted by Meryl, Rhianne's job is to provide healing and protection to the party as they risk life and limb drinking themselves into an early grave. Her job responsibilities have changed only slightly since coming to the Black Pits. Well, she's certainly an interesting character. And Andor, who's a neutral good human archer. He has the good dexterity for being an archer. And pretty decent stats all around. Andor makes his living as a guide and bodyguard for those that wish to venture into the wilds, outside the protections offered by guardsmen. Excuse me. He picked up this profession from his father, who trained him in the ways of rangers. Meryl offered him a significant percentage of the plunder from her adventuring scheme, and Andor agreed to waive his initial fee. But when the next week was spent drinking in taverns, he decided the job wasn't for him. Unfortunately, he was taken along with the others before he had a chance to tender his resignation. Mm-hmm. I'm hitting I for inventory. I guess you can't see their inventory at all. Well, they might come completely with nothing. And then you outfit them. Zelnik. Male. Gnome illusionist. True neutral. Zelnik is a good name for a gnome, definitely. An illusionist. Intelligence 17. You have pretty good stats. At least for his primary skills. Or stats. When asked about his past, Zelnik is refreshingly forthcoming. In time, however, one experiences this refreshment rapidly turn into boredom as he drones on about the books and scrolls he read during his adolescence. If someone can sit through the entire tale, they may be able to sift through it to discern that he hails from Baldur's Gate. Studied under the Kalashite Archmage Tabish Saim, and once had a memorable encounter with a particularly lusty Argonian maid. Are you kidding? Okay. Plus the thing with Talos and the shouts. I know Talos in the Forgotten Realms is not the same Talos as in the Elder Scrolls, but really, the thing with the shouts has it. Seems like a nod as well. Zelnik is otherwise happy to offer his magical skills at the highest bidder, or in the case of Meryl, someone who agrees to a date at some point in the future. Okay, looks like he takes after Mort from Planescape Torment a little bit. Wondering whether or not this promise is still valid after being taken to the Black Pits, Zelnick has so far been unable to extract an answer from Meryl. It sounds like Mort. Okay, so we got a cross between Mort and whoever wrote the Lusty Argonian Maid books and in the Elder Scrolls universe. Okay. Play. I don't know if I should go core rules. Slightly stronger enemy types appear. I hope you guys aren't disappointed. I'm going to choose normal for this. Just because I know there's a lot of fighting. So I'd rather not play the fights over and over and over again. I still might end up doing that. But, yeah. I mean, if I was playing this just myself, I'd be going through story mode. Although there probably isn't much of a story. But, yeah, I'd be going through story mode just to mess around and see the story. But I know you guys want to see me fight and stuff, so here we go.
What? What? Where are we?
What? What?
Who spiked me drink? I was just in the tavern talking to Myrna. Hey, I saw those folks there too.
You better sober up.
We're in some kind of fighting pit. Look out! Monsters!
Oh. I don't have control over this. Oh, this is my party. Okay. Tasloi. Oh, this shouldn't be that much of an issue. Well, what do we have? Okay, we got a dagger. He's got a dagger. He's got a club. Andor is the archer, but he just has a club. Okay, we don't have ranged weapons. Gallus is, hold on a second. Gallus is the barbarian. The archer, let me just see. Well, they probably all have armor class. Well, he has 8 and 6. That's pretty good armor class. Hit points. Pausing to take a drink here. Hit points are here. 12. 15. Armor class 7. That's pretty good. I can't move you. These two have to stay back. You're staying back, and you're staying back.
I am here.
No spells memorized. Nope. Okay.
Battle!
Indeed.
To battle!
I must hit 0.
It is done.
Such a habit.
To battle!
Onward!
They run up anyway.
It is done.
I'm not pressing 0. I'm selecting.
Certainly.
When I select these guys, See how they switch? Why is that happening? There's no loot?
Certainly.
Who that?
You have qualified.
Thanks, I guess. If fighting Tasloi qualifies us.
What's next? Ah, this group. Are they awake yet? Oh, rouse yourselves, you lice-laden layabouts. Stand and salute your new master, Baeloth the Entertainer.
You sound quite full of yourself. If you think fighting three Tasloi qualifies us, you're sadly mistaken.
You may also thank me, since your meaningless lives are about to become infinitely more exciting, and quite likely, abbreviated.
Oh yeah, a thousand thanks. Definitely, you've done us a great favor.
You have been brought here by an unlucky roll of the die. Well, unlucky for you.
Yeah.
Gather some equipment, gird your loins, and prepare to fight. Najim, my obedient slave, take care of them.
Najim?
And don't forget to give them a little spending money.
Oh, I guess we're gonna buy things that these are vendors then? Najim, I presume?
As my master commands, take these coins, speak with the dealers gathered here to equip yourselves. Once you are prepared, report to Master Baeloth. Do not attempt to escape, lest he command me to snuff out your life.
Where are we? What's going on? I demand an explanation.
You have been summoned to this island fortress by Baeloth. We are in a complex known as the Black Pits, dug by Durgar slaves. You are to fight in the battle pits for the amusement of Baeloth's guests. I have answered your questions. Now prepare for battle.
It seems like a bad idea to choose that. It seems I have no choice. Shall do as you ask, for now.
Prepare yourself for battle, mortal. When you are ready to face your fate, speak with Baeloth.
I don't like it, but I too feel the effects of this undying gear. One day. Well, can we talk to each other?
It is done.
Not a problem.
Certainly.
Certainly not. We can't talk to each other. I thought that was a mushroom my con had made in there for a second. Okay, so we got 2,500 gold. And there's six of us. Oh, can I switch us now? Thank you. Who's got the best charisma? 13, 11, 16. Meryl's pretty good. 14, 16. Yeah, Meryl, we'll stay later so we can get the best prices on things, hopefully.
Certainly.
Hello?
What do you interlopers want? If it isn't a light weapon, then off with you.
Come now, we're both in the same predicament. What's the harm in being friendly?
Friendly? These usurpers walking intruders? Ha! If Baeloth hadn't taken over, my people and I would already have driven you out. Or to your grave, more likely.
Okay, so we've got a German drow or dwergar. I doubt it. Baeloth may have captured me, but he enslaved you first.
I'm no more a slave than you are. Maybe a little less.
How did Baeloth manage to bind all of you?
Through trickery and foul magic, of course. You did notice he's a drow, didn't you?
You said you're less a slave than I am. What do you mean by that?
I meant only that... never mind what I meant. You are as much an intruder as Baeloth. This territory belongs to my people, the Durgar.
I thought it was pronounced Dwergar. Interesting. Now let's do some trade. Well, 75. Scimitar hits pretty well, right? 1d8. 1d6. Well, what are these people proficient in anything? Fighter, proficient in long sword especially. Gallus is good with two-handed sword, two-handed weapon style. And of course he's good in the longbow. Alright, so we need a long sword and a two-handed sword. Well, he's only got, I think, a long sword. So, Wakizashi is a one-handed. Proficiency type. Oh, it's not even. No, I don't think we want any of this stuff, actually. Okay, then you?
It is done.
You fools have no idea what you're in for. You'd best arm yourselves as heavily as possible. I can help with that, if you've enough coin.
Why do you look so grim?
I find little cause for amusement since that drow unleashed his monsters on us, which never would have worked if we had even one worthy man among us.
Who are you talking to?
No one who matters. No one who listens. No one who answers me anyway.
You keep looking at that Dwergar selling light armor. Who is he?
Did you come here for gossip or arms?
For arms, of course. Show me what weapons you have for sale. Alright, so... okay, long sword, here we go. 1d8. Now, as a bastard sword, 2d4, that's better. One-handed. That's better, because you're always guaranteed 2. So instead of doing 1 through 8, you're doing 2 through 8 damage. And then a two-handed sword for him, I believe. 102. So she is the longsword one. So there we go there. And he'll take this. He's the one with the two-hander. Okay. So we want a bow for this guy because he's really good with that. And then slings for the magic users, and then for her, a warhammer. Did I see that? A warhammer. I think she had a warhammer. Sword and shield style, though. A warhammer, though, is, oh, she's a priest. I'm not familiar. This is on the Priest of Talos. Wait. Ooh, may cast lightning bolt once per day. Gains one use at level one, additional use. And storm shield. Okay. One round per level of the caster, protecting from lightning, fire, cold, and normal missiles. Alignment restricted to... Okay. I'm not sure, because she's a priest, so she can't use... I'm not familiar with sword and shield style. I guess that just means, in this case, weapon and shield style? Well, I can just give her a big warhammer, either one.
Indeed.
Here's a warhammer. A warhammer, is it throwable? Wait. No. It's really cheap. It's only... two? Well, she's proficient in this. 1d4 plus 1. And it's... oh, it is one-handed. Oh, okay. If I get something big like this, it would be two-handed. Okay. So I'm gonna get her a warhammer. And then... possibly a shield as well. Oh. She looks quite different in these two pictures. Alright. What do you have?
It is done.
What do... oh, more of your sword. Alright, I'll get you whatever you need.
My sword?
My name is Devlin Darylon. I deal mainly in ranged weaponry. What can I get you?
Shades of Khalid, indeed. How did you come to be here, Elf?
I'd better not waste time talking to you. Baeloth hurt me more.
What's so funny?
I'm a slave to his will. Please don't bring me to his attention.
You're a jittery fellow. Sounds like something Imu would say. What has Baeloth done to you?
Forget I said anything. Please, just buy something before he comes over. I don't wish to annoy him further.
Oh my god, man. Get a grip on yourself. I need ranged weaponry and ammunition. Alright, so... composite longbow. Oh, it's pretty expensive, but... well, wait a second. See profession in a certain sort of bow. Longbow. Alright.
Certainly.
I forgot to stutter here. Alright, so longbow. Thaco plus one. And he's not proficient in crossbows, unless we get him a composite longbow, which is still proficiency type longbow. Damage plus two. Requires 18 strength though, which I don't think he has. This requires 6 strength. Let me just go check on this. Nope, he does not have the strength for that.
Indeed.
Alright, so unfortunately it's just going to be a regular longbow. And then arrows. And then bullets for the two, oh, there's slings, actually. Okay, never mind. I was like, let me just make sure there's slings. Figure someone else would sell those, but no. Alright, so, two slings. Up to 80 here. That should be fine. I mean, oh, he can identify things if you want him to. If we find anything worth identifying. This way they'll stop running up, because even though I wasn't selecting them, they kept running up afterward anyway. Alright, so these people over here. Well, it's Baeloth himself. For some reason I thought he left. Bellow Gulp Blue Fingers.
Greetings, surface dwellers! If it's potions you seek, then my friend can brew something special just for you. You may call me Baelagulp.
Oh, you speak for him? Your friend is a giant talking mushroom?
He is not a mere mushroom, but a sentient being known as a myconid.
I'm not surprised
you haven't encountered one before. Most live in the lower reaches of the Underdark.
I haven't seen much of the Underdark yet. It's what I first thought, that he was a myconid or something like that, but then I thought it was a hat.